a dark night.
Hey everyone, and welcome to this week's movie review of Dredd, starring Carl Urban. The over-law-abiding cop of justice hasn't had an easy run in media for years. His comic was more of an overseas hit, and didn't make quite the same impact in the States as it did on its own home turf. And the Stallone adaptation of the comic did not do the property any justice whatsoever. If anything, it made it a joke, and at best, a guilty pleasure for some movie patrons, but that was about it. From then on, Judge Dredd would be relegated to comics, so when it was announced that Dredd was getting a reboot, I was a bit skeptical. I mean, yes, it needed one, but could such a character even carry over to film, especially after all it went through? And was Hollywood even willing to have a comic book character played by a known actor not show his face at all? Because comic book films are notorious for showing their heroes unmasked. From Spider-Man to the Avengers, it happens all the time. I mean, why pay an actor millions to never show his face? It would be easy to let this film pass, and I wouldn't blame anyone for thinking so upon a general glance, but if you do, you will be denying yourself one hell of a movie, because even my general perceptions of the film were wrong. Dredd tells the story of megacity officer Judge Dredd, as played by Carl Urban, who must take a rookie for her last evaluation to become a judge. But things naturally take a turn for the worse when the city's block gang leader locks the judges in the building in an attempt to kill them in order to continue her criminal empire selling the narcotic known as slow-mo. The most interesting thing about all of this is the fact that the movie is very upfront and extremely direct. It's a shoot-em-up type of film, homaging action movies from the 80s, and its premise is very simple. Get from the bottom of the building to the top in order to capture Mama and end the drug bust. Dredd himself even points out the film's simplicity and directness towards the end of the film. And while sometimes this could result in a movie lacking substance, it avoids that problem here. Dredd is direct, but it isn't lazy and most certainly not lacking anything for what it's doing. And the choice for this direction was great, considering that over-padding would just be pointless and would let the film fall victim to the same campiness and lameness that the Stallone film did. Some may also try to point out that this film is a carbon copy of The Raid, since they are the same film in concept, but you must remember that Dredd was in production first, despite The Raid being released first. Dredd had to go through a lot more post due to the visual effects of the slow motion camera work. This resulted in a later release date, but it was always ahead of The Raid. And if we are going to point fingers at who copied who, then the guilty party here is The Raid, because Dredd was written and entered production first. Speaking of its production, it most definitely shows its merit and quality because this is one good-looking film. Cinematography is excellent, with great camera placement and sleek movements. Set design are slick and add to the film's depressing universe. But out of all of these, the new slow-motion technique for 3D works best in any format you view it in. Usually, I could care less for 3D in films, but when done right, it can make for a great time, and this is one of them. Oh, and the slow motion isn't your traditional stuff either, or the crap you see in the Resident Evil movies. No, this is the type of shit you see on the Discovery Channel. The speed of the camera is set to track all motion in slow motion and in stunning HD quality. You see every ripple and movement in a way never applied to film before. It isn't simply moving slow, but showing you how things truly move when viewed in such a manner. It's actually using real science, dammit, and it's fucking sweet! And for those who aren't too impressed by this, well, you get to see extreme violence with this technique, which is even cooler. Speaking of the violence, it's cranked to a pretty high level, so much so to the point where it should please any and all gore hounds. I mean, this is one bloody and violent as hell movie, and is where it best homages the 80s action film. But what's best about this is that it's almost exclusively done with practical effects, and not only does it look great, but you can't really tell the difference between it and pure CGI. The line is so blurred, it's crazy. Techniques like this are the ones that should honestly be implemented in more films. The rest of the visual effects are comprised of a combination of practical effects aided by CGI, which was a great move by the production team. Sound design is also strong and surprisingly effective, as I did not think that electronic music could be used to create scenes of tension and dread, and the bass increase of the score during the action scenes and dramatic moments only further assist the film. Performances were all around great, from side characters to our three leads, playing their deadly game of cat and mouse, but it is obvious here that Carl Urban stole the show. His performance as Dredd was excellent, and he did it under a mask, with only his chin and voice as acting tools. That is straight up badass and a sign of talent. Someone nominate this man's chin for an Oscar, dammit! But with all jokes aside, he was seriously great in the film, and it was just so much fun watching him scowl and react to injustice. He also emotes well despite having no face in the film, and retains a grainy, intimidating voice without sounding ridiculous like some actors do, such as the case with Christian Bale in the Nolan Batman films. Despite all of this, his most impressive feat was actually homaging Stallone's speech about being the law from the original film, but without keeping the cheeseball effect from the Stallone film. Now that is simply amazing. The man took the very little good from something bad, used it, made it better, and did it without taking any of the bad from the original material. That's just crazy! Pacing is set to thrill ride in the film, as once it starts, it never lets go. And whether you see it in 2D or 3D, it does not matter, because it does not lose quality either way, unlike most 3D films. Writing is also great, and dialogue is on point and direct. Dredd takes cues from classic 80s action characters such as Rambo in First Blood and barely speaks. As a matter of fact, he only speaks when he needs to, and despite being the main character, he has less lines than other side characters do. Most of the humor in the writing lands right, and the film does great justice to the comic and its source material, which should please fans. Honestly, this is one of the best comic book films ever made, and one of the best films of the year. It's really sad how this film was overlooked, and even worse, that it had such a terrible distribution. I honestly couldn't find a screening for this movie when it was out, and I live in a major city, so you know there was either a blunder with the distribution, or the studio simply didn't care. But either way, to deny yourself this film is to deny yourself a great time. Dredd gets a 9.5 out of 10.
Do not bring that trash up in here, motherfucker!